When the E464 error appears on a Samsung mini split air conditioner, it means there's an IPM overcurrent issue. Now, this overcurrent can happen due to both temporary and permanent reasons. First, let's talk about the temporary causes, and I'll also provide some solutions so that you can easily fix them. A customer brought the PCB to us and mentioned that the E464 error was showing up. The first possible issue could be related to electricity. If for any reason the electrical supply exceeds 253 to 255 volts, this can also trigger an overcurrent error. Similarly, if the voltage drops to around 180 to 170 volts, the overcurrent error can also occur. In this case, it's essential to properly check the electrical supply and ensure it stays between 220 and 230 volts. A fluctuation of 10 to 20% usually won't cause such problems, but the voltage should not go above 250 or drop below 170 to 175 volts. If the electrical supply is stable, the unit will function properly again and the E464 error will automatically disappear. Another major cause could be a dirty outdoor condenser. If the condenser is extremely dirty, the E464 error is bound to happen because the IPM will overheat, leading to an overcurrent issue. Therefore, keeping the outdoor unit clean is essential. Once the condenser is cleaned, the unit will work perfectly fine as the IPM and the compressor will relax, resolving the problem. Now, let's talk about the permanent faults that can cause the E464 error. If the outdoor PCB becomes faulty for any reason, this can also trigger the error, and you won't be able to fix it without repairing the PCB. Additionally, if the compressor winding gets short-circuited, it can also cause the problem. Another scenario is if the compressor pump gets jammed while the winding remains intact. In this case, the system will try to run the compressor, but since the pump is jammed, it won't be able to start. As a result, the PCB will try to supply more current to make the compressor run, but since it can't start, the chances of getting the E464 error are 100%. This would also be considered a permanent fault, and the only solution is to thoroughly check the compressor. If the winding is short or the pump is jammed, the compressor will need to be replaced to fix the problem. Now, let's discuss the potential problems in the PCB. The IPM is installed here, and its UVW terminals may seem fine when tested with a multimeter, but when power is supplied, something else can happen. For instance, the 15-volt supply used for bootstrapping might not be available at a specific point. The system won't be able to detect it, but when the PCB tries to run the compressor and the voltage isn't there, the system won't work and will give the E464 error. In this case, the IPM may need to be replaced, and doing so can resolve the problem. There are also a few ICs in the system that help the microcontroller detect whether the 220-volt supply is stable and if the DC voltages are also correct. Three ICs are used for this purpose. One of them detects the main electrical supply, 220 or 230 volts, and sends this information to the microcontroller. You can see that there are two microcontrollers installed here. One is the main microcontroller, and the other controls the IPM. The main microcontroller is responsible for controlling the entire system, while the second microcontroller controls the IPM. Now, the voltage status is provided to the main microcontroller. Here, you can see an optocoupler that sends the information to the microcontroller about whether the 230 volts is coming in properly. If, for any reason, the voltage is too high or too low, the microcontroller can give us the E464 error. After that, there's another operational amplifier installed here with the model number MV324Q. This one provides information to the secondary microcontroller. If there's any fault in the system, this microcontroller will pass the information to the main microcontroller, which will then shut down the system. Additionally, there's another operational amplifier installed, also with the same model number, MV324Q. It's located here, and you can see there are three shunt resistors installed as well. Now, there's a possibility that if, for any reason, one of these shunt resistors becomes disconnected, the system could encounter a problem and give the E464 error. However, this will only happen if a single resistor is disconnected. If all of the resistors are disconnected or short-circuited, the E464 error won't appear. Instead, a different error will be triggered. You can also see the wires here for measuring. The voltage from before and after the shunt resistor is sent to the operational amplifier. The output from this amplifier is then passed to the microcontroller via transistors. The microcontroller uses this information to monitor the system for overcurrent conditions. If the system detects an overcurrent issue, this operational amplifier will trigger the E464 error. Moreover, if the reactor is not properly storing or discharging the electric current, it could also lead to this problem. Another permanent issue that could occur is with the temperature sensor. specifically the compressor's temperature sensor. If this sensor fails, the microcontroller will try to supply more current and voltage to the IPM to keep the system running. Therefore, the discharge pipe sensor must be in good working condition to avoid triggering the E464 error. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.